Some of you may have seen the Autoline piece on the Tesla Model 3. Autoline is an industry YouTube show that reads press releases from car companies and puts them to promo footage of the vehicles they are talking about. But earlier this week, one of the hosts, John McElroy, tested the latest version of Autopilot on a Tesla Model 3. And well, there were a few problems with this review, but what is interesting to me is that it is a perfect example of how old school car guys do not get Tesla at all. It is like handing an iPhone to your grandmother. Not that all grandmothers don't get the iPhone, but hopefully you get the analogy. If we go to the portion of this video where John tests Autopilot, anyone who has a basic understanding of the Autopilot system in its current configuration, version 2019.8.5, knows that he is making some major mistakes here. The first indication that he does not know how to use the system is when he takes it out of Autopilot to change lanes.
Indicating it's in Autopilot mode. But I gotta get over a lane, so as soon as I turn the steering wheel, it goes off.
He just needed to put on his blinker and it would have changed lanes automatically.
Now I'll tap it back on.
He then puts it back in Autopilot, but because he's inexperienced with the system, he pulls the wheel and knocks it out of Autopilot. And then he thinks that Autopilot is still on, but it's not. You can see this because the Autopilot indicator light is off. Clearly, he does not understand the system. The car is still in adaptive cruise control, but he is so out of touch, he thinks the car is actually driving itself.
See how it does. Will it slow down for this turn? Holy crap, it is. It's making the turn.
Because Autopilot is off, of course the car is not going to steer itself. But John thinks it is on, and he criticizes the system for this.
But it would drive right off unless I turn the wheel.
So here he turns Autopilot on in the middle of a turn. This is an example of how really amazing the system is. There's no other consumer car out there that could do this.
The car is handling it all by itself, and it's doing a pretty good job right now.
Of course it is. It works when you don't turn it off by jerking the wheel.
And now let's see how it merges onto the freeway. And it put on the steering wheel automatically.
He means the blinker here.
It turned into the lane, but the guy behind me is flashing his headlights because I'm going too slow.
Yes, he adjusted the speed, but not enough. The car would have done this automatically if he did not adjust the speed with the scroll wheel manually when he first entered the freeway.
Set the speed limit to 75.
Here we see the first warning that he is not putting the correct pressure on the wheel. This alert says apply pressure to the wheel, but he does not see this. To give him the benefit of the doubt here, he's making a video and talking us through this, so his attention is not 100% on the car. For those who do not understand Autopilot, if you keep both hands on the wheel balanced, it does not think you're there. It's just like keeping your hands off. There's no electrostatic touch, or there's no squeeze in the wheel. There's no sensors in the wheel that allow it to know you're touching it. You just need to pull it a little bit to the left or a little bit to the right. This is what most people unfamiliar with the system do not understand. They compare it to Cadillac Super Cruise. The Cruise system is a good monitoring system because it monitors your eyes, but Cadillac put all this effort into the eye monitoring system because their car will never be fully autonomous. It's always going to be a system that you have to pay attention and watch the road. On the other hand, the Tesla system is built to be a fully autonomous car. It just needs to have continued improvement on the software to where it will eventually be fully autonomous. Elon explains how this is exponentially improving in a podcast he did with Lex Friedman.
Do you think there could be benefit gained from driver monitoring?
If you have a system that's at or below human level reliability, then driver monitoring makes sense. But if your system is dramatically better, more reliable than a human, then driver monitoring is not, does not help much.
You're optimistic about the pace of improvement of the system. That from what you've seen with the full self-driving car, computer.
The rate of improvement is exponential. In fact, I think it will become very, very quickly, maybe even towards the end of this year, but I'd say I'd be shocked if it's not next year at the latest, that having a human intervene will decrease safety.
So back to John, and he continued driving here, and he has now a second warning on top of the screen. After the first dialogue warning comes up, top of the screen flashes blue, giving you a second warning. And when this is on screen, the system will not change lanes automatically.
And we should catch up to a truck.
Now the blue is off, so he did bounce the wheel a little to the right or left, applying enough pressure to the system to know that someone's there paying attention. And it does change lanes.
That's pretty cool. There's no other car that can do that right now.
Now, right here, when he is going into the clover leaf, the warning comes up again because he does not understand how to apply pressure to the wheel.
Now the big test is coming up. We're coming up to a clover leaf. Second, now the turn signal.
After the first dialogue warning comes up, the top of the screen flashes blue, giving you a second warning. And when this is on screen, the system will not change lanes automatically.
Turn signal's on.
Now here, he turned the wheel too hard and autopilot disengaged. Someone familiar with the system would not have done this. It is not hard to get the hang of it. And now here, between lanes, he tries to activate autopilot. You need to be in the center of the lane to activate autopilot. Of course, it's not going to work if you are halfway in a lane. It's not a system error, it is a user error.
Disappointed. It could not handle this clover leaf, or it wanted me to put more pressure on the steering wheel.
Yes, it could not, because you did not understand the type of pressure you needed to apply to the steering wheel. Sorry, John, but it is very easy if you are shown by someone who understands how the system works, and it is clear you do not understand how it works.
So overall, autopilot can be pretty impressive. There are certain situations that it handles really well, such as changing lanes automatically. But there's other things that make this really not all that easy to use. In fact, I'd say if you've got autopilot on, you better really pay attention to what the car is doing, because it ain't as auto as they say it is.
Now, this end statement sounds like he understands autopilot and is commenting as an experienced expert on the system, when he obviously just showed us he knows nothing about the system and does not know the basics of how to operate it. Unfortunately, this is all too common when old school car people review the Tesla. Now you know a popular YouTube show points out another shortcoming on one of John's other shows, Autoline After Hours. One reporter who covers the auto industry completely does not get it at all.
Sandy also brought up that a lot of the big automakers bring in consultants to answer questions, and he said that he's met these consultants and he thinks they don't understand the auto industry. So that's interesting.
Right.
Then David Welch from Bloomberg, I really think he doesn't get it. He kept talking about things like how Big Auto's dealer network is going to help them. And I'm like, dude, that's dude. What's killing them.
Right.
This is just a few examples of how the auto industry does not get Tesla, and I think they are spreading a lot of misinformation. I made this video to hopefully help squash some of these concerns, illuminate people on the truth, what Tesla is really doing, and hopefully help push us to a cleaner, brighter future. Thanks for watching.
In the future, any car that does not have autonomy would be about as useful as a horse.